Hi everyone, and welcome to the next part of the series on Django Fundamentals. Okay, so what we're going to be looking at now is apps, okay? So we'll just be learning a little bit about apps and the concept of a Django app, okay? So I've just got here just an article that I made, okay, which I'll go through with you, and then we will do it practically with a demonstration, okay? So first of all, let's understand a Django project. So we know that a Django project pretty much is a collection of settings, configurations, and apps, okay? And we can have one or multiple apps in a project. So we, of course, can see our project here, Taskly. Okay. And now the Django app. So a Django app pretty much is an application that has used to serve a unique purpose. Okay, and we could say each app that is created in Django has URLs, views, models, and templates. So we can see as an example here by our project, we have a urls.py file. So basically, when we create an app, it will have a we will also create a urls.py file, views.py file, models.py file. We'll have all of that in it. Okay. And we can see here. So if we have a simple project, okay. You will generally only need to create one app, okay? So this might be a blog, for example. So we can see here an illustration of the concept of Django apps that I created here. So the black here would represent our Django project. The green, these are the apps that we have created ourselves. These are apps that we create, and we can call these internal apps. The orange, okay, these are apps that have been created by others, okay? So these can be Django developers, or anyone of the sort, okay? And these apps are installed, or you could say plugged in, by these plugs here, by pip. So if you remember when we installed Django, the package, the virtual environment package, we always used pip, okay? So try and see pip as the plug to our Django project. So for example, if we're here on our server, just cancel it, and we want to install a package or an app, we can say pip install, let's say Django or virtual env. Okay, so this is how I'd like you to try and understand the concept of it. Okay, so external apps, okay, this is what you install with pip. Internal apps, this is what we create ourselves, and we will be creating an internal app ourselves, okay? Okay, so basically try and see it like this. So we will be creating now just one app for our Django project. We will have other apps as well that are installed with Django, but we are just going to create an app ourselves, just one. Okay, so let's get straight to it. So to do that, we must just open our CMD, so we can just clear this up. Okay. Now, what we can do is we can simply just say Django admin start app. And then you just want to give a name for your app just right next to it here. So just make sure that you are in your Django project here. So you can see I'm in Taskly. So very important that you make sure of that. And I'm going to call my app, let's see, I can call it... let's call it to do. Okay, so this will be like a task manager, so we can call it to do. This is our app. So let's enter. Okay, let's check if it's been created. And here we go. So we can now see that we have our app here. And as we saw, it has a views.py, models.py, admin.py, and it also we will create urls.py as well. And so on. Okay, so this is our Django app that we've just created here. Okay, so basically all of our main functionality and everything will be done here, the main parts, but we'll also utilize other files as well. All right. Okay, so let's see what's actually in our app file here, folder. So we can see we have a couple files here, so let's walk through them. So admin.py, okay. So this is a configuration file for Django admin. So pretty much Django comes in with a sort of a built-in administration page called the Django admin panel, which we'll look in later on. But basically here you can register models, okay, which we'll also get later, we'll deal with later on. Okay, So basically, we will register our models here and we'll see them all on our Django admin page. Okay, so apps.py. So this file just provides us with some information about our app. So in this case, our app is called Todo. So we can just close that. So no need to worry about that for now. Test.py, also not that important. So this is where you can create unit tests and carry out unit testing. Okay, so this is test.py. Views.py, okay, this is where we will manage our HTTP requests and all of our responses. Okay, so yeah, so pretty much I just want you to worry, or not worry, just focus on the views.py file, models.py file, and admin.py file for now. We will also create a urls.py file that look like this, but more on that later on. But just for now, just focus on views.py, models.py, and admin.py. Apps.py and test.py aren't that important, so you don't need to worry about that. We can also see we have a migrations folder here. So whenever we create migrations, of course, they will sit in this nice directory here. Okay, but more on that later on. As you can see, we also have an init.py file, but we don't need to know much about that, so we can just ignore that for now. But pretty much that's it. So this is our Django app that we just created. And to just reference it, pretty much this is kind of what we created here. Okay, so we've created our internal app here in our Django project. And as we can see, it's going to serve a unique purpose. Okay, since it's called Todo, so you can obviously assume that it's going to have something to do with a task sort of manager. Okay. And we can see that it's consisted with already views and models so far. Okay. So that's it for the concept of Django apps. I hope it made sense, but don't worry. We will do lots of practice and so on in the next set of videos. Okay, so that's it.